Hi, welcome to the shop. This is another part in the Miniature M1911 series. The last time we worked on the slide, but we'll take a break on this because I have to take some decisions on how to finish it. Instead, we will make the sear. I already printed out the drawing and converted some of the measurements to metric and 1/3 of the actual size. Okay, we're over at the lathe and I'm ready to prepare the stock for the milling operation. I will face the stock material on both ends and put a little chamfer on it. I'm using this combination tool. Tom Lipton showed this once on his channel. You can face with it, you can turn with it, you can put a chamfer on the left and right side, and you can also do internal chamfering. Okay, this is the template in 10:1 ratio for the sear. It's machined from 3 mm phenolic. I'm going to mill a flat on this stock material. So it's indexed when I'm clamping it at the wife. I put the part on a parallel, I clamp it, and to seat it, I prefer a small copper drift. I don't like to hit it with a depth blow hammer or a soft hammer. And then the parallel snug under the parts. Set up the part on the pantograph machine. The template is also set up, and I centered the workpiece with the DTI in the spindle. Now I'm going to rough out the contour using this 2 mm carbide end mill. I'm taking a cut of 1.5 mm depth and just hogging away the material. Later I will do a finish cut using this new 3-flute high-speed steel end mill. I'm using a stubby carbide drill because I don't need to send a drill for it, and also they drill a very tight tolerated hole. Partial finished part, which is it has the profile mill and the hole drilled, clamped in the vise, and we have a 10 millimeter, 0.6 millimeter thick slitting saw on an arbor in the color chuck, and we're going to cut the slot in the sear. We're back at the milling machine. I clamped my small grinding vise into the big one, and I've checked up the part still hanging on its stock material in the small one. I'm going to pick out this radius with a 1 millimeter carbide end mill so I get a sharp corner. So this is going to be the last machining operation. We are over at the lathe. I've checked up the part in the 3-jaw chuck. I put a narrow parting tool, carbide parting tool in it, and I'm going to touch off on the front face, move in the thickness of my parting blade plus the final thickness of the part and part it off. I'm going to put a bit of color on the front face so I can see when I'm touching with the blade. It's now I'm moving over 1.2 millimeters, that's the thickness of the part. Now my blade is flush with the front edge of the part. I'm retracting the parting blade and I move over 2.62 millimeters. I clamp the carriage so I don't get a mishap, and I'm ready to go. I'm adding some cutting oil.